Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Welcome to our MIAD Integration B 2022 series. Today we turn our attention to the problem 3 of the first semifinal. We will compute this integral. If you are new here, do not forget to subscribe. So we want to compute I. Honestly, I found this one really hard. I don't know what you guys think, but let me know in the comments. However, the key today is going to be hyperbolic functions. You will understand shortly. So we start by the term under the third log. And we notice that 17 over 4 is just 4 plus 1 over 4. So this quantity turns out to be x minus 1 over 2 squared plus 4. Actually, this form a squared plus 4 is very interesting here. You will see in a while. Next, basically what we want to do is that we want log of x plus 1 over x to be of the form log of a squared plus 4 up to a multiplicative constant. Because looking at this expression, if a equals 2 times the sinh of a number t, a squared plus 4 will be 4 times the cosh square of the same number t. So to do this, we raise x plus 1 over x to the power 2. We have this. Next, we write 2 as minus 2 plus 4. So the side with minus 2 will yield x minus 1 over x squared plus 4. So we have the form we're looking for. Nice. We apply the log here, and we have 2 times log of x plus 1 over x is of the form log of a squared plus 4. Actually, a equals x minus 1 over x. So the integrand we write as follows. So we have that 2 here, and it is balanced with log of 1 over 2. So I rewrite as follows. So I can be split in three parts, I1 plus I2 minus I3. So I1 is going to be this integral, which is straightforward to compute, since this function is a constant one. And I2 will go with the log of the log of this part. I3 will go with the log of that other part. The intuition here is that we want to prove that I2 equals I3, so that I equals I1, and I1 is straightforward to compute. I1 is going to be this value log of 1 over 2 multiplied by the length of the interval we are computing the integral on. So that length is 2 minus 1 over 2. That's what we have here. And at the end of the day, I1 equals minus 3 over 2 log 2. We start by I3. We want x minus 1 over 2 to be 2 times the sinh of t. So we use this substitution here, and dx is going to be 2 times cos t dt. So now we move to the upper limit. We set x0 equal 2, and x0 minus 1 over 2 is going to be 2 minus 1 over 2. So we divide it by 2, and we multiply by 2 to have everything right. And then we know that 2 is e to log 2. That's what we have written here. And then we see that it is 2 times sinh of t0. And t0 equals log 2. That's good. Now for the lower limits, we know that x minus 1 over 2 is going to be 0. So that t here equals 0. And then I3 is equal to the integral from 0 to log 2 of this function. Now, 2 times cosh t dt is dx, and we have replaced x minus 1 over 2 by 2 times sinh of t. So this is 4 times sinh square t plus 4. But we know that sinh square plus 1 equals cosh square. That's what we have next. And at the end, we replace 2 times cosh t by e to t plus e to negative t. So this is I3. So we turn to I2. So we want this to be also 2 times the sinh of t. So this can be achieved using x equals e to t, and then dx is e to t dt. So we replace here. So we have integral from negative log 2 to log 2. And then we replace x, which is e to t, and this is e to negative t plus 4, and dx is a to t dt. That's what we have. Okay, that's good. We will write as follows. because this is 2 times sinh of t, and I2 is equal to this integral. But the issue we have here is that the integral is going from negative log 2 to log 2. So what we can do is to separate I2 in two parts as here. So C1 is going to be this integral from 0 to log 2, and C2 is going to be the integral from negative log 2 to 0. So we want to do something with C2. So here we use a simple variable change. We set V equals negative T so that dV equals minus dT. That's what we have here. So if we apply this, we are going to have the integral from log 2 to 0 of this expression e to minus t minus dt, but the minus allows us to switch the upper limit and the lower limit. So we have the integral from 0 to log 2. So I2 is the sum of these two integrals. So we can apply this sum, and C1 will have e to t, C2 will have e to negative t, so that I2 equals this integral, and we see that I2 equals I3. But we know that I was I1 plus I2 minus I3. Since I2 equals I3, then I is equals to I1, and then I equals negative 3 over 2 log 2, and this is the answer. Thank you for your attention. Again, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and post your comments. Bye.